question. Amen. At this time, we have a speaker on the talk by Brother Jeremy Ford. You can come.
I knew Billy Joe and Beyonce and all the family from Facebook, you know, down in Facebook. And she go to her house all the time. She showed me much love. I prayed hard for Billy Joe and, you know, God chose to call him. But this is the thing that I asked God for. I asked God if he would he bring him back to his feet? And would he back him up by doing it? Well, he called him home, but he did back to the doctor. You know, the doctor was saying that he was going to be gone to Abby. He ought to, you know. But he lived another 2 weeks after this. And God did what I asked him. He back to the doctor. Now, I'm going to tell you something. This thing isn't serious. This is a bloodline thing. It's coming from Adam and Eve. You understand what I'm saying? Everybody feel like when Christ died on the cross that it automatically took away everything. But I'm here to tell you that ain't what God told me. God said that he sent Christ him to give man a chance for eternal life. Ain't you ever wonder why Judgment Day ain't been canceled? Ain't you ever wonder why Yelp ain't been canceled? See, all of these things are still here. The only way that these things are going to be truly canceled when you come before God. See, God is an awesome God. He's given us chance for our through Christ and gave us love, showed us love through Christ, but we still got to go through the process. He's a process God. He's precise. He moves by something, not by minute. Let me tell you something. If you look back at California back in the last couple of weeks, I don't know how y'all been following the news. God told me back a while back that he was going to bring up the poor and needy and bring down the high and mighty and shout at him like out when he speaks. You know, a lot of people probably would say, well, he went even further than saying he was going to bring them down. He said he was going to shout at them like glass. Now, if you look at California back a couple of weeks ago, did y'all see that? 22 counties hit within one shot. Ain't that so? That's power. 22 county is hit within one summer. We're talking about buildings, neighborhood. And I'm going to tell you whose neighborhood it was. Just hang on for a minute. And it was neighborhoods and wine distilleries. You know what I'm saying? Big pile of wine distilleries. He snatched them clean out the ground, wiped out everything, even tore up the foundation that the building was sitting on. Let me tell you something. God get fed up with something, he fed up. And I'm going to tell you like this right here. For the poor and needy, the suffering, get ready. You're getting ready to come up. And confirmation was California and Las Vegas, neighboring states. You understand what I'm saying? God is playing. When he said that he was going to come to the poor and needy's rescue, he meant that. And he's getting ready to show out. So you know, all these big, high, mighty folk that walk around with all these millions of dollars and won't help the poor, turn their back on the poor, laughing and talking about the poor. You better get ready, because your time is getting close. I'm telling you, you're going to see more and more. Hey, you ain't got to take my word. Just watch. Stay focused and watch what I'm about to show you. I'm going to show you something that's in the house. God getting ready to show somebody. He ain't playing. He going to snatch up some things. He fed up with the poor need to be in this tree. He told Esau back in the day, when Esau, I know y'all know Esau, right? Y'all know Esau? Esau was the brother of Jacob that the blessing was stolen from. When that blessing was stolen from Esau, he turned evil. You know, he began to do evil things. He started stepping on the poor and needy, treating the poor and needy wrong. Well, God told him, said, okay, the city of Edom, which is Edomite, said, I'm going to take them, I'm going to take the Edomites and wipe them out. Said, because they've been standing on the poor and needy. Okay, so what he did was he wiped out Edom. Told him, say, you put your treasures up way above the cloud and high fly high like the eagle. Well, I'm gonna bring you crashing down. He didn't say down. He said crashing. Do you understand what I'm saying? Crashing down. That means I'm not gonna play with you. I'm gonna wipe you out and let the poor leader watch me destroy you. You understand what I'm saying? He's getting fed up. All of that came on down to where it's at now. The high and mighty still thinking they can do this. They walking around here with their millions of dollars, buying all this land, but ain't giving nothing to the poor. You know what I'm saying? And God done got fed up with it. And it's getting ready to change. Just keep your eyes open. You ain't got to take my word. Keep your eyes open. I told my cousin right there, Faye, back here a couple of weeks ago, I said at our house. I said, Faye, something's getting ready to happen. I said, God finna make a believe out of somebody. What happened, Faye? Day or so later, what? California got hit there. Then the massacre at Las Vegas. Now, let me say a little bit on that there, then I'm gonna sit down. The massacre at Las Vegas, let me tell you what happened. The night before that happened, there was a preacher out there. White preacher at that. He told little people that they were going in there. He said, y'all don't need to be doing this. He said, God, you got fed up with this. If y'all go in there, something bad will happen. You know what they did? They mocked him. Laughed at him. Called him crazy. And everything, the next night, all of them got snatched out. You understand what I'm saying? Let me tell you something about that massacre. God told me he was going to shout them like glad. What was the first thing that man did before he started shooting? Can y'all tell me the first thing that he did before he started shooting? Before he fired the first shot, what did he do? He broke the windows out over here. He broke the windows out over there. What did that glad do? It shot to the ground. See, that's what I'm talking about. See, God's word ain't playing. And he's gonna show them more and more. And he brings confirmation when he brings. You see what I'm saying? He don't just say it, he brings confirmation with it. He's awesome. You know what I'm saying? He's dad. That's the way I respect him. I call him father, I call him creator, but the most thing I call him dad. You understand what I'm saying? Not afraid, not ashamed to call him dad. That's my dad. You understand what I'm saying? I had an earthly dad. He gone. My mom gone. All of them gone. But now, I got a dad like no other. You understand what I'm saying? Told me, said, I'll be your mama and your dad. Oh, my God. I don't worry about what man say about me or what he think about me. I care less about that. You know, I done lived out in the streets. I did all of it. I know what it's like. So you think I care about what man saying? Oh, you know he ain't gonna never mount to nothing. Yeah, he said the same thing about Joseph, didn't he? Said the same thing about Job. Said the same thing about Moses. Oh my God. Woo, I keep going on and on. I can't live it alone. It's in me. The spirit. I can't stop it. It's all about me. You see what I'm saying? I'm down with my dad. I love him. He spared my life back in 2009. Oh my God. I was in the hospital real sick. You know what I'm saying? On the point of death. And an old lady came in my room I had never seen in my life. And lady told me, she said, son, she said, God told me to come in this room and talk to you. She said, you're gonna come out of here unknown. You know, here I am, I've got tubes all in me, I'm wondering. She said, you're gonna come out of here unknown. And it happened just like she said. 2 days later, I was at home. And now I can't be stopped. Can't be shook, can't be took. Oh my God, let me leave it alone. Oh God, ooh. I know how awesome it is. I don't fake it, I don't play it, I'm real with it. Do you understand? It's all about God, not about man. Man walking around and thinking he owns it something, running something. This is God's word. My goodness. He's been beat. He's been defeated. Why are y'all worried? Stop worrying. plays the song, gave you a song to go through. You know what I'm saying? You ain't got to go to man. Go to God through Christ. Oh my goodness. Lord have mercy. When I leave this world, I'm going to be the steward of what I want to stand on. You understand what I'm saying? I ain't playing with nothing. When I leave this world, I'm going to be proud. When I lay on my bed to die, I'm going to be proud. Because I'm going to serve it. I'm going to honor it. I can't stop. Oh my God. Woo! Right. I can't stop. Oh, right. It's gonna be all right, baby. You know, you just keep your head up. God got you. It's the bloodline. Yeah. It's coming through the bloodline. Came from Adam and Eve. That's what caused it to happen. That's why death was here from Adam and Eve. You understand what I'm saying? Christ came here, but he couldn't wipe. He didn't wipe that away. Now that still got to come. You see what I'm saying? Christ was on the ball that came here to give us a chance. All the things you got to do is keep walking right. You see what I'm saying? Oh, my goodness. Oh, I can't.